Hey, hey, Country View, this is your Wildcat welcome for Thursday, March 30th.
And a happy birthday to Annie C. in fifth grade and Mrs. Lowry.
Oh, happy birthday. Mm-hmm. On this thinking Thursday.
I've got my thinking brain on. I'm ready.
I bet you'll figure this out then.
Okay.
You ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Okay. What kind of garden does a baker have?
What kind of garden does a baker have? An herb garden. Oh! A flower garden.
Yes!
It just took me a little bit.
Flower, like F-L-O-U-R.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Not like
baking flower.
A baking flower. Mm-hmm. For sure, for sure.
That's good.
Nice job.
Thank you.
You did have that thinking cap on.
Just came to me.
Wowzers. Well, today what we're going to do, we are going to honor and celebrate Black history. And so the 15th Amendment was adopted in 1870 on this day. Mm-hmm. That's incredible to think about. Mm-hmm. And so the book that we're going to feature in honor of this is The Amazing Age of John Roy Lynch. And the author of this book is Chris Barton.
So John Roy Lynch spent most of his childhood as a slave in Mississippi. But all of that changed with the Emancipation Proclamation, which is part of the amendment. Number 15. Suddenly, people like John Roy could have paying jobs and attend school. While many people in the South were unhappy with the social change, John Roy thrived in this new era, and he was appointed to serve as a justice of the peace and was eventually elected into the United States Congress.
Yes, this is an amazing story of, once again, people overcoming mm-hmm. in order to show that they matter, they have voice, and they are important.
Mm-hmm. It's an important book to check out.
It really is. Mm-hmm. Well, scholars, I'm Miss Beam.
And I'm Miss Rush Hour.
Make it a thinking Thursday.
And we'll see you at our next Wildcat Welcome.